Okay, I'm done with the seventh NFT, almost in there. Seventh NFT, here we go. The seventh one is ready. Isn't that beautiful? Seven NFTs for 28 hours and 30 minutes. I have 9,993 more. I'm joking, of course. From the very beginning, I knew that these NFTs are actually generated automatically, but I wasn't really familiar with the whole process itself. And spending over 30 hours, actually, I have figured it out, the whole process step by step. And in this video, I will create a brief overview of the five steps you need to take if you want to generate 10,000 unique NFTs. And in following videos, I will show in details each step, so each video will be dedicated to one of the steps, but the idea in this video is for you to grab the whole concept of how to create and list 10,000 NFTs, or again I say any number that you wish to have. And no worries, no coding experience is needed. I'm not a developer, but I have figured out how to get the ready to use code and to use it if you want to generate your own collection of NFTs. And it's really cool to create and list thousands of NFTs, because if you market them well, if you build a community and you build the expectation for the minting day, you can make really good amount of money. And in one moment, you can find your NFTs on the marketplace for insane amount of money. For example, a few days ago, I have bought my favorite Bored Ape Yacht Club monkey with the pink balloon for 36 Ethereum, which was above $125,000 as a value. Isn't that insane? You really didn't do that, right? Of course I didn't. I would never spend that amount of money. But I really like those. And if you look at them, they're not just funny. There is something in common, right? What you can notice is that the background for some of those is the same. For example, that one and that one have the same background. And what you can notice as well, that their faces are similar. So they have the so-called layers. And creating such a collection with NFTs, you are actually about to create layers. So the first layer is the background. Then you have the body. Then you have the head. And you can have different mouth, different ears, eyes, nose, attributes in the mouth, for example, like my favorite pink balloon, or you can have a cigarette, you can have different hats, different dress, for example, shirts or t-shirts, or it could be just a naked monkey, or whatever comes to your mind. So the first important thing to notice is that those collections are quite similar, and they are built by placing a layer over a layer over a layer. And by combining the different layers, actually you are getting 10,000 unique NFTs or any other number. Really doesn't matter. You can create as many as you wish. So if you're ready, I will show you the steps you need to go through, and you can have an idea about the whole process. I will drop links below, so we can have an idea what you need to download, from where you can get it. And by the end of the video, you will know if this is the right thing for you or not. And I will save you a few hundred dollars, because this is how much you would pay for one collection if you hire someone from Fiverr, for example. And actually, these guys are following the very same method. So what I want you to do is just sit back and see the whole process. So the first important step is to come up with an idea that will be awesome. People will be willing to buy. You will be able to sell most of your NFTs just on the minting day. And if you're watching that video, I guess you already have the idea. If you're an artist, probably you have a few ideas already, and you're just looking for the way to create thousands of NFTs, so you won't need to paint them one by one, which obviously will be super time consuming, and you don't want to spend that time. And you already heard about methods where the artists are generating minting those NFTs within minutes. And this is exactly what I will explain in a second, and I will share what exactly you need. But if you have no idea, I will give you a few tips from where you can start. First, you need to decide, are you about to imitate already an existing NFT collection, such as the CryptoPunks, which could be considered to be the beginning, and they are the inspiration for the ERC-721 standard. And if you look at the top collections on OpenSea, you will see that most of the collections are with 10,000 pieces, which is some kind of standard nowadays. And of course, you can create more, you can create less, it really doesn't matter. So if you're about to imitate an existing project, think about how you can make it more interesting. What is messing with the project you want to improve? Are you about to create some metaverse or implement those NFTs into an NFT gaming, which is one of the most popular and exciting niche nowadays in the NFT world? Or you will just make them funnier with more attributes. For example, the Bored Ape Yacht Club, which I already mentioned, has already an insane community. And I think those monkeys got really popular because they have so many different impressions. Some of them are sad, others are bored. Third are extremely funny. And I think building some kind of impression on your NFTs is super important. Or just try to make them live. So when people look into your NFT collection, they will see feelings, they will see them sad, they will see them happy, they will see them frustrated, excited. Try to make them live, so this will attract more buyers. But what's really important before you do the next steps that I'm about to show is to visualize the whole thing into your head, which will be super helpful and easier for you to prepare the collection. Just like when I'm recording online courses or recording videos, I always visualize the whole process, the videos, how I'm about to structure them, what I'm about to say, where I'll be shooting, which camera, microphone I'll be using, how exactly I'm about to do it. And I always make a plan before recording each video, so it's easier for me to follow the steps after that. Now, it's very important to use a program that you are comfortable with. For example, Photoshop, but I know that Photoshop is a little bit complicated for most of the people, unless you are an artist and you're comfortable with it. Plus, it is a paid product. One of the free programs you can use is MyPaint, which you can download, and it is good enough if you want to create layers for NFTs. But if you're just starting out and you want to create some NFTs, create the layers and follow the next steps that I will show you, you can use any program that you are familiar with. Or if you have some friends that are better in Photoshop, or if you have a friend who is a designer, that would be even better. So you can ask him to help you out. Because if you have really a clear idea what you want your collection to look like, then it will be easier for you to explain it to someone who can help you out with the design. Because at the end of the day, it's important the NFTs to look nice. For example, the Bored Ape Yacht Club NFTs, I like those because they're all funny. They all have those emotions on their faces, and I just find them entertaining. Of course, the prices nowadays are ridiculous. And I'm pretty sure that in the very near future, some ready solutions will be out there, like websites or apps where we can upload the layers, or we can create the layers inside and generate the whole thing. But for the moment, these are the steps we need to follow. Now, before you generate the NFTs, you will need to visit a few websites, download a few programs, and let's go straight to the point. So the first one is the Node.js, which will be familiar to you if you are a developer. If you know coding, the whole thing will be easier for you. If you're not, don't worry. All you need to do is to download the appropriate file according to your computer and the specifications that you have. So it depends if you're a Mac user, if you are using Windows. Just select the program that fits best to your machine. The next website you need to visit is GitHub, from where you can download the ready code. There is a guy called Hash Lips, or this is at least how he calls himself, but he was open-minded enough to share the code with everyone. So once you visit that page, you can download a zip version of the code. As well, the guy has a small YouTube channel just like me where you can follow along with him and you can learn more about his work, which I found useful because he's actually sharing how he does that and he shared the ready-to-use code. And the third website I want you to visit is the Visual Studio Code, which is a code editor, and this way you will be able to access the code and actually generate the NFTs. And once you install it, you will be able to get to work and you will find out that it's nothing really complicated. Step number four is actually to generate the NFT collection using the ready code that we already downloaded. And I will just show you how the code looks like. So I will select the folder that we have downloaded. So you can see that on the first part we have the layers with the background, and then we have the ball, the bottom, the eye color. If I click on any of those, you will see the actual layers displayed, or it could be the top lid, high top, or lid eyeball. They are inside the code and you can see the whole thing in a code. So I know it looks really complicated, and it was for me as well. I spent enormous time of researching the whole process and looking into the code and learning how to do it by myself. And I will dedicate a video about how to modify with super easy to use steps. But in this video, I want you to grab the idea that we are using that ready code shared from the Hash Lips developer, and we are implementing our NFT layers so we can generate the NFTs at the end of the day, and we will be able to upload them to OpenSea. And there we go to the next step. How do we upload 10,000 or more NFTs easily? So after you are done creating the NFTs, what you have to do is to list them on OpenSea, for example. And I would suggest you to stick to Polygon blockchain because there are no gas fees involved. On the Ethereum blockchain, there are gas fees. This is where the action happens. But if you're doing it for a very first time and you're just practicing and you want to learn the whole concept, you can just practice on the Polygon blockchain because it's free. There are no gas fees involved. So obviously it's a lot of work to upload 10,000 or more NFTs one by one. Of course, it is not impossible, but it will take you a long time. So one of the solutions I found is to use a program called Minimouse Macro, which remembers and records your mouse movements, which means that if you upload one NFT and follow all the steps from add item to uploading the NFT and then giving it a name, a link, description, you can record the exact movement of the mouse and then repeat it again and again using an Excel sheet, which will help you with all of the names, and it will be super easy for you this way to repeat the same process again and again. So basically you will need to do some work on an Excel sheet and have your collection listed with the different names, and then start from the first NFT, upload it step by step. But while you are doing it, you record your mouse movements exactly where you clicked with this mini mouse macro program, which will repeat the same thing, taking the next number with the next name and clicking exactly on add an item, uploading the next picture, and then giving the name, copying it from Excel to the OpenSea, and so on. So basically the program will do the whole thing for you, and you will need to upload just one NFT. After that, it will do the whole thing by itself. This is so far one of the easiest solutions that I have found. And if you have any other ideas, I'll be super happy if you drop them below so the video will be useful for everyone watching it. And in following videos, I will explain each of those steps that I described described in detail, so you can learn more about the code itself, how you can modify it even if you are not a developer, or how you can build the layers on Photoshop or on My Paint, where it is much easier if you are a beginner and not a designer. And as well, I'll be giving you more tips and ideas on how to create a unique and fantastic NFT collection that you can market very well. So if you like the idea of creating 10,000 NFTs, let's go to the next video and I will show it all step by step. So if you like the idea of creating and listing 10,000 NFTs, I really hope that you have found that video useful. If you did, please support it with a like button. This will be useful for my YouTube channel and it is good for the YouTube algorithm. I'll do my best to record in the upcoming weeks the videos for each step, so I'll bring you more details about each one. And if you don't want to miss any of my future videos, make sure to smash the subscribe button. I'll see you guys every Monday, Wednesday and Friday. Thanks for watching. I love you. Take care. Oh, and I forgot to tell you, if you like any NFTs, you can just print them. It's super cheap, but don't tell anybody.